Hare Krishna. We are an illusion, but we are not an illusion. Some people, when they understand some preliminary ideas of spirituality, they start saying that everything is an illusion. And not only everything out there is an illusion, they even start saying that our sense of I-ness is also an illusion. That nothing exists, even we don't exist. Now this is taking the concept of illusion to an extreme which furthers and aggravates the illusion. Why is that? Because illusion is something which is experienced by someone. If there is water, if there is no water in a desert, but we see a mirage where we see water. So it is we who are in illusion, but we have to be real to be in illusion. Illusion means false perception. But false perception can, perception of any kind, false or true, can happen only when there is a true perceiver. If there is no perceiver, then there is no perception at all. So there cannot be illusion unless there is some foundation of reality, there is some real observer. And the Bhagavad Gita explains that we are real because we are parts of the Supreme Reality. We are eternal parts of Krishna. The Bhagavad Gita explains in 15.7, Mamai Vamsho Jeeva Loke Jeeva Bhutah Sanatanah Manah Shashthani Indriyani Prakriti Sthani Karshati. It says that we are all eternal parts of Krishna and we are eternal. So we are always His parts. That means He is the Supreme Reality and we being His parts are also part of the eternal reality. We are also real. But presently what has happened? Manah Shashthani Indriyani. We are driven by our mind and senses. And being driven thus by our mind and senses, we are dragged into illusion. What is the illusion that we are dragged into by our mind and senses? That illusion is to think that the objects of this world will fulfill our longing for happiness. We all long for lasting life, lasting love, lasting joy. Whereas everything in this world is temporary, it is ephemeral, it is fleeting. So the illusion is to mistake the temporary to be eternal. Mistake the things that can give us only little pleasure to think that they will give us lasting pleasure. So this illusion can be removed when we connect ourselves with our source. When we devote ourselves to Krishna by practicing Bhakti Yoga, then we who are the infinitesimal reality become bonded with the infinite reality in an eternal bond of love. And that is illumination. That is liberation. That is freedom from illusion. To realize our spirituality, not to realize our non-existence. Thank you. Hare Krishna.